Hello, hello, CraftingMantis here, and welcome back to another episode of Life in the Village 2. So in the last episode, we ended up getting to work, adding in some more jobs, as well as some housing for our lovely citizens, and today we're going to be working on productive bees. However, there were a few things that happened in between episodes, which, yeah. So first and foremost, we officially got raided. So as you can see right here, it says mysterious warriors have been spotted. Now, luckily I had my recording software up. I didn't have my mic on, but I did get to record it. So it said it was in the northeast. Well, I went northeast and I kept looking around. I couldn't find them. Well, I'm like, okay, well, I'll go ahead and come back. And then I started hearing bows firing, and I discovered that the, and yay, case is done with a belt, yay! But I discovered that the barbarians were actually attacking Maya 1 guard, and so we were able to actually take that out, and yeah, not too much of a problem. I only saw two, so it definitely wasn't a very big raid. Now, the other thing that happened in between episodes is that I went out and I went to go find some vanilla bees. Now, that was rather funny because I ended up bringing them back on leads. And so, apparently, the achievement is balloons because you end up carrying around these little balloons that look like bees. The tangly bees that look like balloons. But yeah, it was really funny carrying those guys back. Oh my gosh, yeah, it took a little while because, yeah, they weren't very close to here because I'm not really close to just a straight forest. Everything is spruce and stuff around here. So, yeah, but we got them back so that we can actually get moving forward on our productive bees, which is awesome. Now, in between episodes, I also ended up hiring a new people. So I have Chloe, who I actually want to deal with right now because of the fact that, one, she actually has influenza. So she is the first one that has actually gotten sick. However, we also have had two of our citizens die, and that's one of the reasons why I've kind of been on a kick to try to get things set up in between housing and guards and stuff like that. So managed workers, we want to hire Chloe. So yeah, she's not the best in terms of agility, but the thing is that she said that she wanted to be a guard. So let's go ahead and recall the worker. So there is Chloe. See, look at all this stuff. She is not feeling good at all. Yes. So she needs carrots and potatoes. So that is what I have brought her. I don't know how much she needs, but we are going to give her carrots and potatoes so that hopefully she can start. Yeah, there she goes. So she's going to start healing. Now with this, we want to go settings. We don't want her to be an archer. We want her to be a knight. Yeah, we want her to be a knight. There we go. Okay, oh, yeah, I'm working on it. Yeah, she's getting all nice and healed up. But yeah, so I did, because we've already got one archer over there, and so I wanted to have a knight on the other one. And I may switch it around. I need to check to see if their stats actually, matter. But yeah, so here's Angelo. He's the other guard. Now, originally I had somebody down in the mine, but yeah, that wasn't exactly working very well. And it looks like our miner actually needs stuff. Yeah, so we've got Chloe, and then we've also got Theodore, who is that way somewhere, it looks like. Yeah, but Theodore is actually going to be most likely the person for the warehouse. So the courier, I think, is what the job is. But that is, yeah, we're not going to be doing the warehouse today. But I figured that would be for the next episode because of the fact that things are starting to kind of fill up. Our forester has been hard at work. We've got our miner and all of that. So as we kind of expand things out, we're going to need more storage and somebody to actually take it into the storage. So that is something that I'm planning for the next episode, is to do the warehouse, which we're going to end up putting over here, as well as some more housing. And then I've also actually got plans for the fishermen, but I don't know if I want to do that in the next episode. But today we are going to be working on the productive bees. So let's go ahead and get to it. So I wanted to bring you guys over here. This is where I'm going to be putting the bees. So I put these guys over here. These are the vanilla bees. And so it's just a nice little area for them, nice and enclosed. I kind of use the same style as the rest of the build, so that, we can try to kind of make it fit in. Now, I'm not 100% sure if I want to keep this one here, because there are a lot of bees. In fact, if we come over here, let's go ahead and do at a productive bees. Yeah, we've got all of these bees that we may want to, actually bring in. Now, not all of them are actually, produce stuff. Because right now, the bees that I have, they don't produce stuff. They are used to breed in order to get bees that produce stuff. So if we come over here, as you can see, we're definitely getting the honeycomb and the honey. And if we, I did this to, yeah, to try to make sure that the villagers don't get in here and release the bees. Yeah, hey, just perfect timing. But yeah, so I made the advanced spruce beehive. And so this is where our lovely bees will reside. And then I've got some glass bottles so we can actually get the honey as well. But the advanced beehive, let's see, where is that in here? Here we go. So it's basically honeycomb, campfire, the shears, some of the planks, depending on what color you want the beehive, and then the actual spruce beehive, which takes three of the honeycomb. So I ended up going out. I got some of the honeycomb, basically enough in order to create that beehive, the advanced beehive. So that was five honeycomb. That way, you know, we could actually get the production going on this because we will... Oh, and yay. Okay, I can actually take these out. I wanted to make sure to have grass in there. But, yeah, so we now have the production of the honeycomb, which we're going to need in order to create more of these beehive things so that we can end up getting moving forward on our stuff. And, yeah, I need to clean that up. In fact, what I might do is I might actually put the beehives in the back of my house and kind of line it up that way. But let's go ahead and come down here. I wanted to show you guys because I went, unfortunately, last week my computer was going absolutely bonkers. And so I ended up having to re-download the mod pack and I ended up losing my journey map. Because if we come over here, yeah, I've got some of it. Because like here, we got the resource area just by itself because I had the waystone out there so I could teleport out there. So, and then the, you know, the one over here. Ooh, red bee. What? Reed. Oh, that's a reed bee. Okay. Oops. Apparently I hit the D twice instead of the E. Yeah. So I travel all the way back here because I, no. Because I actually ended up bringing a donkey back because there is a stable. Oh my gosh. I keep doing that. But yeah, there's a stable right here that ended up having a donkey. So I ended up, apparently double-clicking does not help. But yeah, so I traveled all the way back. So that's why that's all explored. And then I've been exploring. This is a forest and stuff that I've been actually getting the vanilla bees from. And there's actually a flower forest over here, which is really, really pretty. But yeah, so I lost the journey map because I remembered to bring the save over, but I forgot that the journey map was actually done via the instance and not the save file. So, yeah, I lost that, but that is all right. So let's go ahead and open up this because, you know, and I say it's all right because of the fact that I went out and I started exploring and I got even more of the bees. And so I've got two of the resin bees. I've got two green carpenter, three of the ashy, one of the slimy bee, which was really cool because, yeah, all I saw was a slime block. I'm like, why is there a slime block in the swamp? And that was why. And then I've got the digger bee in a sturdy bee cage I had gotten from a village. And then a mason bee in this. So these, you know, these are kind of different. In fact, I should do that because, yeah, I don't have too many of all of them. And then these are blue banded bees. So pretty much I think all of these, other than the slimy bee actually produces stuff. But like the ashy mining bee, the green carpenter bee, the resin bee, the blue banded, the digger, and the mason, I think all of those guys, they don't produce anything. And so they're just there to breed in order to actually get ones that do produce. So what I am going to do is I'm going to find a final location for these guys. Because, yeah, one, it's going to be a waste of glass because of the fact that, yeah, I already built it. But that's all right. I'll get more sand and stuff. But yeah, so I think I'm going to move it over here, probably create a nice little area here and maybe do like a garden or something. So bring it maybe over the cave here. And so I'm going to get all of that stuff in a position and get the beehive set up so that we can start breeding some bees. All right. So I wanted to bring you guys in real quick because, yeah, I am finding that I'm going through tools a whole bunch. And then I also ended up needing to get obsidian because I found out that one of the bees that we need in order to get moving forward is actually in the nether. Granted, I do not plan on going to the nether today. That'll be a project for next episode. But as we are getting things set up, I want to get some tools put together. So one of the things that I found is that there's this leveling system that you can end up doing by having rings. So if we come over here, so we got three rings, right? And then if I remember, let's, yeah, I have it in here. And so let's make, we're going to make a sword. And then let's see, a shovel and an axe. So let's do that. So axe, shovel. Okay. So we've got all of these tools and stuff like that. So all of these, they get the same, it says luck when worn. Oh, okay. What? Stabcraft. Is that because of the sword? It is. All right. So as you can see here with the pickaxe, it has the level and stuff. So it says ores mine 345. I've already got it up to legendary. And as you can see in the purple text, it shows that it has different things, you know, different abilities. And so I want to do the same thing for these things, especially if we're going to be going out into the nether. I want to have some, you know, some good tools and stuff with me. So let's see, I'm wondering which one is better, opal or sapphire. I mean, I don't think it really matters. Let's see if we do that. Yeah, it stays the same. So let's do the sapphire on that one, and then let's do the opal on the sword. There we go. So that'll give us some good weapons, and then, yeah, so we gain experience when mobs, and then chopping blocks or slaying mobs, and then when, yeah, just from use. Okay, sweet. So we got all kinds of tools and stuff, so I just need to continue putting stuff together in order to actually, yeah, like, get the lovely stuff done for the bees. And so while I'm doing that, yeah, I'm one short. I am one diamond short. So I still need to go out and do some more mining. So hopefully I will find another diamond so that I can make one more piece here. Oh, and then, yeah, so let's go ahead and get these on. And then there. Oh, hey, look at that. Sweet. Leave it to the quest to be like, oh, hey, you need some diamonds? Here, have some diamonds. All right. There we go. Okay. And we get three more. Sweet. I am loving these achievements. Oh my gosh. All right. So there we go. So we got those. I'm going to go ahead and finish up with the bee stuff, and then I will bring you guys back to show you what I have done. So it has taken me a while, but we have the first 4 units of the bees. This is a little bit smaller than these just because of space and all of that, but we've got all of these in, which has me super excited. Now, I haven't done the lights on this side yet because I got to thinking, because of the number of bees, we might actually need to do a double layer of these because, yeah, oh my gosh, these are already pretty much full. So we've got the vanilla bees in here producing away, and then we've got the blue banded, the green carpenter, we've got the resin bees. Ooh, and I actually need to grab one of these guys. Oh, and they all run inside. Okay, that's not helpful. Yeah, they're going to take a little while to get out, but that is all right. We can see if we can catch the reed ones. So we got the ashy mining, nomad, digger. We've got the neon cuckoo. So the neon cuckoo shows up in the blue banded nests. So they'll actually take over there. And then the nomad will actually take over the ashy mining. So I definitely been having to be very careful of that. Now we've got the chocolate mining here, and this is the breeding pen. And then if we come around here, this should be our reeds. Hopefully I can grab one of these guys. Any of you out? Oh, you're almost out. Okay, sweet. I'm going to grab you. And then we'll come over here. So we got the reed one over here, the slimy. So this one's already producing. That's one that you can actually find that produces. We got the mason, and then the rest of these are ones that I don't have yet. So I ended up going through the book. So it does have a big book of bees, and you can make this with using the bee cage and the book. And the bee cage is just a honey bottle and any kind of plank. And then wanted to show you guys. So I got one in there, and it's already produced a lot of the slimy cones. Now, if you come in here, this can be used in order to make either a slimy cone block, or you can use it in order to get slime balls, and then you can also trade it with, you know, the mechanics. So, oh, wow, and he gave me 3 more. Holy cow, definitely a very, very productive bee, to say the least. Now, let's come back over here and find the resin bee. Here we go. Let's see if we can catch one of these guys. Yeah, this one, yeah, they're almost all out. So I can end up grabbing one of these, and then we can breed these guys over to the breeding pen. And we can breed our very, very first one, which is going to be the silky bee, which I'm super excited about because that'll be the first one that we'll be able to actually do. So let's snag one of these guys. All right. Sorry. Don't mean to disturb you. So now if you use the regular bee cages, they end up getting used up. So as soon as you release a bee, it gets used up. However, if you can get the sturdy cages, and I got these from villages. So that definitely would come in extremely handy. So with this, we've got these two lovely, lovely bees in here. So let's go ahead. We're going to do that. And they should create a little baby bee. Yes, there he is. Oh my gosh, you are adorable. Well, come here. All right. Okay, let's get out of here. That way we can get this guy out and we can check. And yes, it is indeed a silky bee. So let's get this lovely little one over here. So this is going to be the new home for our silky bee. Oh my gosh, you are so cute. The baby bees in this one are definitely so small. Yeah, it took me by surprise because I found a nomad bee about this size that was out in the wild. And it's like, oh my gosh. But yeah, so this guy should just kind of fly around, and sooner or later we'll end up actually getting into the hive. So let's get out of here, not releasing him. But yeah, so that is so awesome. So we have our first ever bred up bee. That is so awesome. Now, like I had said before, there's another one that is needed for a lot of the breeding. It's a crystalline bee. And so I'm going to have to go to the nether in order to actually get that bee. So that is what I am planning on doing for next episode. So I'm going to continue working on kind of making this look all pretty and make a decision as to whether or not I want to go up or if we want to try to go out. I mean, we do have more space, and I may even move like most of the producing bees over into like a different segment. Maybe we'll have to kind of play around with that, but we also need to get the warehouse in place. And so that is another thing that we need to do. And so the warehouse is going to get placed over there. So I figure once, you know, we gather up the materials for that, then we can get that going. So we'll get the warehouse done, I don't know if I'm gonna be able to do a time lapse on it. It is an awfully big build. So I might show you guys, you know, how it looks and then kind of make a determination as to, you know, whether we can actually do it, because it is big, especially once you get to the level 5 ones. But yeah, unfortunately, I think it was Theodore. Theodore decided to go exploring in a cave without any weapons or armor or anything like that. And yeah, he didn't survive. So I've blocked up the cave that he ended up wandering into. I've definitely found that it is not good for villagers to not have a job because they have a tendency to wander off. And so, yeah, we definitely don't want that at all. So we'll have to find out ways to keep our villagers occupied. But yeah, I definitely hope that you guys have enjoyed this episode. It's definitely super fun to be playing around with the productive bees. I'm going to continue kind of messing around with them, you know, off camera, see if I can't get some more of the bees. I'll go through all of them and see if any more of these can actually be bred together. And instead of just the, you know, with the crystalline bees. So super excited about that. So yeah, so I definitely hope you guys have enjoyed this episode. And if you did, definitely hit that like button.
If you're new to the channel, click the Mantis icon to subscribe, then hit the bell button to get notified when I put out additional content. Want to check out more of my videos? Try the one on the left, or you could check out the playlist on the right. That's it for now, but I'll see you guys in the next episode.